Hello, my name is Lindsay Sikora, and I am the Research Liaison Librarian for the Health Sciences here at the University of Ottawa.
Hello, my name is Patrick Labelle. I'm a Social Science Librarian at the University of Ottawa. Today, we're here to talk to you a bit about systematic reviews, a research methodology that's been around for a while, but that's gaining popularity across many different disciplines.
So your first question probably is, what is a systematic review? So a systematic review aims to take a very focused research question with pre-selected eligibility criteria and using empirical studies to answer that question. So what you're trying to do essentially is present your research in an unbiased way with different steps involved. And that's what we're here to talk to you today about, are the different steps involved in this systematic review process.
So the first and most important step is planning. The more time you spend preparing your review, the better. If it's not clear in the first several steps, then you might experience challenges further into your review. By having a clear outline, the rest of your review should flow more smoothly. You want to start by ensuring that no previous reviews have been done on your topic. If some have been published and that they require updating or improving of their methodology, you could also determine that it's worth following the pursuit of conducting a review. You can search for reviews in the Cochrane Library or in the Campbell Collaboration for previously published reviews. You can also look in a tool called Prospero for protocols of published or of upcoming systematic reviews. You can also search in databases that are specific to your research area to find out if systematic reviews have been published. And you can always search in Google Scholar to find out as well if a review has been done. You'll then need to assemble a team. Your team usually consists of your principal investigator, content experts, research assistants, a librarian, and in some cases, a statistician. Team members will play different roles throughout the process, but it's important that you don't decide to do this alone. Once your team is assembled, it's highly recommended that you produce a review protocol. This is your game plan. You can use checklists that exist to help you prepare your protocol, but a protocol will typically include your research question, inclusion and exclusion criteria that you'll apply to the studies, your search strategy, a list of the databases that you're planning on searching, any strategies that you'll use to extract data, and different ways that you'll use to synthesize and disseminate the results.
So your next step is identifying. You need to identify the studies that you want to use in your systematic review. So to do that, there are a couple of tips and tricks that we're going to share with you. The first step is your database selection. Okay? So what you're trying to do is you're trying to take your research question and you're translating it into a search strategy, which can be rather challenging. So what you're going to do first is you need to select your databases, and within those databases, they have very select research terms or subject terms, as we like to call them. So you need to identify your subject terms that go with the concepts that are in your research question, and then you need to identify your keywords. Going into this is a little bit beyond this video, but those are really important steps to use in your search strategy, because really your search strategy is what sets the tone for your systematic review. So once you've identified your subject headings in all your different databases, and you've identified your keywords, you're going to need to combine them in a way to get at the articles that you're looking for, so that you can eliminate any of that extra noise or any of those extra articles that really aren't relevant to your search strategy. One way that you can ensure that your search strategy is very strong is that you can get it peer-reviewed. There's a tool out there called PRESS. It stands for Peer Review Electronic Search Strategies. And what you can do is you can get a librarian to review your search strategy to ensure that you're grabbing all the words that you need to grab, that you have the proper spelling, any proper like terms or synonyms that go with searching within that database. Once you've identified all of those within the database, then what you need to do then is you need to do supplemental searching. This kind of complements the database searching that you're doing. And there are different ways to get at this information. So for example, you would search citation references, so a list of citations that you're going to include in your systematic review. Another one is probably your gray literature. This is anything that is not commercially available in the databases. So it includes thesis, it includes dissertations, it would include conference proceedings, any type of government reports, etc. Once you've identified all of these different places that you can get your supplemental searching and your database searching to get your articles together, then it's best to put them all into one spot. We usually do this through citation management. So what that means is we're using a tool, different tools such as EndNote or Mendeley or Zotero, where you're able to take all of your different resources from all the different places, put it into one spot, and remove any duplicates so that everything is there in a spot that you can go to. This then will lead into how you can evaluate.
Once your searching is complete, the fun part begins. Well, it's fun depending on how many results you obtain, but the evaluating stage is where you really start to discover which studies will help you answer your review question. Remember that during the planning stage, you determine inclusion and exclusion criteria. These criteria will now be used to help you select studies. As a first step, you need to screen the titles and abstracts of all the results found during the identifying stage. If abstracts seem irrelevant or potentially relevant, put them aside for the next screening process. Once titles and abstracts have been screened, you'll then need to track down the full text of all the remaining results to proceed with the second screening phase. You will read the article and apply again the inclusion and exclusion criteria that was previously set. Be sure to track the number of articles that are included, retrieved, excluded after title and abstract or full text screening. You'll need to present these findings in a flow diagram in your published systematic review. After completing these screening processes, you'll then need to choose a critical appraisal tool and apply this tool to evaluate the methodology, rigor, and relevance of the studies that are included. Select at least two members of your team to go through this whole entire process. You might first want to test the applicability and test for inter-rater reliability of the appraisal tool before applying it to the rest of the study.
So your next step is collecting and combining the data. What this often entails is creating a data extraction form, and you probably want to do this ahead of time so that you can identify the exact data that you would like to extract from all your different articles. So this could include, for example, the author, the title, and the journal, but it also will include, for example, your population, your intervention, and any other details that really will answer the research question that you're trying to present to your viewers. So once you've created and filled out this data extraction form, and you can do this with different tools such as Microsoft Access or even simple as Excel, many different ways to do this. Once you've combined all of your data together, then what you can do is you can create a very detailed table in order to better represent visually the data and the findings that you have done.
The next step is explaining the findings. The goal here is to answer the main question of your review to allow readers to understand whether or not a particular intervention or treatment is effective. Depending on the review question, you might choose to do either a narrative review, a synthesis, a qualitative synthesis, or a quantitative synthesis, a meta-analysis, or a combination of these. Your synthesis reports and describes important study characteristics, significant differences between studies, as well as critical appraisal techniques and results.
The last step of the entire systematic review process is summarizing. So in order to summarize, what you need to do is take all the data that you have and what you've done as a synthesis, and then you need to write a story. That's really what a systematic review is. It's writing a story. So at the end, you need to decide how you're going to present your story. And this is going to depend on the audience that you're going to present it to. So for example, if you want to write more traditionally, you probably present it maybe at a conference proceeding or within a journal article. And that's all great, but sometimes your systematic reviews are going to inform policy or government reports. So you need to keep in mind the audience and how you're going to present your information that you're doing to the proper audience. Systematic reviews can take anywhere from 6 to 12 months to complete. So you need to make sure that you have enough time to dedicate to the full process of the systematic review process. The other thing that you need to consider is you want to make sure that you have, as Patrick mentioned, your full review team in place before you start your systematic review. And if there are any budgetary considerations, those are also things that you want to consider. For example, for any translation for articles, any type of software you may need to purchase, or any personnel that you need to pay. These are all very important details that you really need to consider when you're doing your systematic review. If you have any questions, you can contact us or anyone at the library, and we'll be happy to help you with any of your steps. Thank you.